Let's be honest, we as a software developers, we had a good run. We created hundreds and thousands of softwares, tools, and if you knew any one of them, it was highly likely that you could be part of the community or part of the ecosystem. And that's the precise reason why we are growing at the rate of close to 1 million per year. And effectively, if you look into the total count, we are more than 28 million as of today. That's a huge number. But things are changing with the arrival of AGI, the artificial general intelligence. I'm sure you must be seeing all the news around you where people are saying that we don't need software developers to code and AI is gonna take software developers' job. That's troubling us, and it should, because things doesn't seem to be in our favor as of today. The sentiments are not very positive. This is my personal opinion, but as much as I hate to say this, I have to say, because this seems to be the reality. Most of the leaders in our industry are actually followers. They follow a particular sentiment. For example, you know, when market is down and other companies are asking their good people to go, and if you are owning a company and you are stable, this is the best time to hire good people for your team. But most often than not, people follow the train and let go of their good people also. And then when the market goes back again, people complain that they are not getting good people. These are just a follower's mindset. A follower's mindset follow as if there is no tomorrow. I mean, if you are owning a company which is stable and if you have great plans for the future, why you follow a trend? Because whatever is good for others may or may not be good for you. And being leader means you have to apply your own brain. You have to do your own calculations, evaluate your own situation, scenarios, and market conditions before taking a decision. Being a leader doesn't mean following just with a thought process that, you know, many people are doing it, then it must be correct. And if things go south, it will go south for everyone. That's not the characteristic of a leader. But unfortunately, we are seeing this trend. So we as a software developers, what we should do? Should we be worried all the time? I don't think that's a good idea, because that may impact our health. That may impact our family life. And this is not gonna be good for any one of us. What we need to do is that, in my opinion, we should go back to our natural roots, the basic instinct we as humans have. What are humans known for? We were explorers. We are explorers, and we will continue to be the explorers, even though we have slowed down this a bit because of all the things that are happening around us that may be preventing us from doing this. Think about it. If it is too easy to go to space, we will aim for moon. If it is too easy to go to moon, we will aim for Mars. If it is too easy to go to Mars, we will aim for Jupiter and Europa. If it is too easy to go to Jupiter and Europa, we will aim for the edge of the solar system. And that's what I want we software developers to do. Become the explorer again. If you look into all the news around the AI, you can look at it in two ways. One, AI is taking our jobs, or AI will take our jobs. That's the normal thing everybody is talking about. The other way to look at it is that maybe AI is freeing me up from the repetitive, monotonous jobs, which doesn't need super intelligence like human intelligence, but can live with or can be done with, you know, a small intelligence just like AI. And if I am saving my time, I can use the same time to do something else, something bigger, something more amazing, which I couldn't do earlier because of the time I was spending in many of the monotonous, repetitive jobs. From my perspective, let me define AI in a very simple terms. Today, AI is just a great automator. Think about AI agents or anything that AI can do. It is a great automator of our repetitive jobs. And whether we like it or not, AI was and will always be about the past. Even if it creates a new programming language, it will refer to the past. It doesn't have the explorer nature what we have to create something totally new. I have seen people getting amazed by AI writing codes, but for some reason, I was never amazed by this. Because this is my personal opinion, guys, but I feel that this is one of the greatest steal of the millions of software developers' work without consent or credit, done by some people who could do this. And I firmly believe that stealing can take you far, but not far enough. And let's see if I can be proved wrong in my lifetime. And that's why I consider it just as a great automator for my work. And here is what I will suggest all of us to do. Divide our work in two things, two distinct things. Doing the right things, doing the things right. Let's use our human nature, the nature of an explorer, to do the right things. And let's take help of the AI to do the things right. And that's the way I see we both can evolve in the future, we as well as the AI. Let's be an explorer again. Let's create things which are yet to be created. Again, let me quote one more example. Around 30 years back, I used to play in a normal Pentium computer, the Prince of Persia game. Today also, if I want to play, I will not play the same Prince of Persia game. The Prince of Persia game also evolves in a way where it has new GUI, the faster response because of the infrastructure and ecosystem that is built around the machines. Similarly, treat AI as an infrastructure for doing something really amazing, something really great. And that's the way I think we, 28 million odd people, should look at the AI and should go ahead with that. I do hope and believe that this video was useful to all of you. Thank you all. Thanks for watching. We will meet again.